Hi everyone, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to discuss media queries. So media queries refer to the way to change the appearance of a web page according to the viewport dimensions. So before I talk about this topic, let me show you the HTML file first. So I have a heading, and after that, I have two paragraphs. And this is the end of the HTML file, which is quite easy. And in order to achieve the correct or anticipated result of the media queries, I have to add one more line inside the head section of the HTML file. I have to include this one. So I have a meta tag, and I have to specify the viewport value. The value should be something like this. Width equals device width, and initial scale equals 1, which is this one. So these two content values are quite important in order to show the correct performance of your media queries. So the first one refers to the width, which is set as the device width. So what does it mean by this one? It just helps me to use the real viewport size as the basis of the measurement. So in some of the devices, the device width might be set as some particular pixel values. In order to help me design the media queries correctly, I'm better off with the real device width. So I just rely on the viewport size to help me do the calculation of the appearance coming from the media queries. And another thing to talk about is the initial scale, which is set as 1 here. And what does it mean by this value? It just says that 1 CSS pixel is equal to 1 viewport pixel. Some of the web pages might be shown a bit differently by zooming out before it is put on the viewport. So if we set the initial scale to be 1, 1 CSS pixel is equal to 1 viewport pixels, so that the calculation coming from the media queries can be reflected correctly on your particular computer that designs the web page. Okay, so let me go to the CSS file. So I want to talk about the general syntax first. To control the media queries, we have to mention the media type as well as the media feature rules. So now I want to show you the basic media types first. When it comes to setting up a web page, it is usually shown on the screen, or the content may be printed out on a piece of paper. So basically, we have two media types. Okay, when we want to make use of the media queries, we have to use addMedia, which is a rule to help me do the media queries. So one of the media types is called the screen. So for now, I set the paragraph to have a red color. So you see all the words in the paragraphs are turned to red. Okay, so this media query simply tells the computer to change the paragraphs to be red when it comes to be shown on the screen. Another media type is simply called the printed version of your web page. So I can do something like this. Okay, another media type is called the printed type, which is simply saying print here. So when it comes to the printed version of the web page, the H1 heading would be turned to monospace font family. So you see, on the screen version, the H1 heading is still using the default font family. But when it comes to printing it out, I will be able to show the other font family. Okay, now you can see that the heading would become monospace characters instead of the original characters shown on the screen version. So the printing version would give me another font family instead of the original one shown on the screen. So that is the meaning of the print media type. Okay, after setting up the media type, we can go to the media feature rules. So the media feature rules talk about the ways to determine the failport appearance. So one way to control the feature rule is the failport width and height conditions. So let me show you one example. Okay, this media query simply tells the computer to change the font size to 30 pixels when the minimum width of the failport is 700 pixels. So now the failport width is not that wide, so you can see that the font size of the paragraphs is still quite small. But how about changing the width of the failport? Okay, when I simply enlarge the window a little bit along the horizontal dimension, we can see that the font size has changed to a larger value, which is simply 30 pixels. So when I simply turn the window to be smaller, right here, you can see that the font size has become the original value. So this is one way of changing the appearance according to the failport width. Another one can be the height of the failport. So let me show you something now. If the maximum height of the failport is 600 pixels, the color of the paragraph would become green. So let me try to change the height of the failport. Oh, sorry, I have to put one more character. Okay, so you see, now the window has been shrunk to a smaller height than before. So when the height is less than or equal to 600 pixels, the color of the font has become green. So when I simply increase the height of the window, I can turn the font to have the original color, which is red. Okay, the red color is simply the instruction shown above. So by the cascading property of the CSS language, we can see that if the failport height is not too small, I will still use the original color, which is red. But when the maximum height is given by only 600 pixels, after changing the failport height, the color of the font will be changed to another one, which is placed on the later part of the CSS file according to the cascading property of CSS. Okay. Another type of the media feature rules can be the failport orientation. So the orientation can be landscape or portrait. So let me try to demonstrate some ideas to you. Okay, if the orientation of the failport window is landscape, the body would have a background color of light blue. So now the width is smaller than the height, so it is still the portrait mode. So I can try to increase the width of the failport. Okay, when the failport height is smaller than the failport width, it becomes the landscape mode. In this case, the background color has turned to another one, which is indicated by the statement shown here, light blue, okay? So when I just turn the orientation to portrait again, you see the background color has become the original one, which is simply white, okay? Another orientation can be portrait, so you can make use of the portrait keyword to replace the landscape keyword here to achieve another different result coming from the media query. Now, I want to show you another property of the media queries called logical operators. So when we have so many conditions joined together, we can make use of the AND or NOT properties to make some more complex conditions. So the first one to talk about is the AND operator. When we use AND operators to join so many media feature rules, we have to make sure that all the conditions are satisfied in order to allow the media query to function. So let me show you another example. Okay, what does it mean by this complex media query? So I have to specify the screen mode, and I have to specify the minimum width to be 600 pixels. And at the same time, I also have to specify the maximum width to be 1500 pixels. So what does it mean by this one? So it just tells the computer to change the text alignment mode when the width is between 600 pixels and 1500 pixels. So now the width should be between 600 pixels and 1500 pixels. So now you can see that the text alignment becomes center. How about changing the width? Okay, now the width is smaller than the minimum width required. So in this case, this part is not able to be satisfied. In this case, the text alignment will not be turned to center. Okay, when I simply increase the width of the viewport window, you can see that the text alignment mode becomes the original one, which is left, but not the center mode. Okay, so we can simply say that the AND operators would help me execute the result coming from the media queries when all the parts of the media queries are correct. Okay, so all the media feature rules should be correct in order to execute this part of the style. Okay. Another way to talk about is the OR operator, which is simply making use of a comma to join the media feature rules. Okay, for now, the media query becomes this one. So I have to make sure that I have a screen media type, and at the same time, the orientation should be landscape. Or the screen type is set and the minimum width is 700 pixels. Okay, so this comma is treated as the OR operator in CSS. Okay, so when this part is satisfied or this part is satisfied, we will change the font style to be italic. So let me try to change the viewport width first. Okay, now the width is beyond 700 pixels. So this part is satisfied. I'm able to change the font style to be italic. Now the landscape mode occurs. So in this case, so the first condition is satisfied. Screen and orientation equals landscape. So now I'm able to change the font family to italic again. So I have two ways to change the font style. One is that the orientation becomes landscape, which is this one. And the second one is that the minimum width becomes 700 pixels, even though the orientation is still the portrait mode. Okay. The third operator to talk about is the NOT operator. It simply tells the computer to do the negation of all the conditions following the word NOT. So let me show you an example, and I'm going to explain more about it. Okay, what does it mean by this statement? Since I have only one condition to do the media query, I have to include OR and before the media feature rule to do the testing. So the NOT keyword here is simply helping me to negate all these parts following the NOT operator. Okay. So the entire statement is simply saying that if the minimum height is not 700 pixels, I'm able to change the heading to another font size. So let me see the effect. Okay, Okay, now the height is no longer larger than or equal to 700 pixels. So in this case, I can change the heading font size to be 3M instead of the original value. Okay, so you can see that I'm doing the negation of all the statements following the not keyword. Okay, so here I just want to say that when the height is less than 700 pixels, I'm going to change the font size of the heading to be another value. So it is important to understand that when it comes to having only one condition of the media feature rule, I have to include all and before the media feature rule in order to apply the not operator. Okay. So this video has talked about so many properties of the media queries. For example, I have to include the meta tag first to help me evaluate the performance of the media queries appropriately on your working computer. And also, you have to make sure that you understand the ways to change the feature rules as well as the media types. And you can also use the operators and or not to help you make some more complex conditions to be evaluated according to the fieldport dimensions. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.